When Jesus saw the great crowd coming, we read in John chapter 6, verse 5. When Jesus raised his eyes and saw that a large crowd was coming to him, he said to Philip, "Where can we buy enough food for them to eat?" When the people are coming in great number, and it is a lonely place, they might have been coming for various needs. Jesus is concerned about them. And they have come to the lonely place. They have walked and come. They are tired. They are worried. The Bible says he raised his eyes and he saw them all with so exclamation. And he is worried about how to feed even before they reach. Do you know, we have a God who thinks about us ahead of us. You may be thinking, now we are in this lockdown. Some people may be thinking that we are going to get only half salary. Some may be thinking only 30%. How are we going to take care of our problems? Oh, so many issues. Don't look at your issues. Look at the Lord. Before you know your problem, your God goes ahead of you. Ahead of you means what? You are thinking about the month of May only today. He's thinking about your June, July also. How to send your children, how to send them to the school, what are the things are going to happen, how he can fulfill your needs. Don't think of your needs. Think of the Lord who is with you, who fulfills all your needs. And the same thing is written in Matthew chapter 15, 32. When Jesus saw the people, his heart was filled with compassion. Yes. And then we read, he fed them stomachful. And once they know that we have a God who feeds us, they saw the miracle and wonder. And then slowly, he takes them beyond their bodily need to the truth who they are, who God is. That's why in today's gospel, Jesus says, your body is useless in the sense it can only ask for food, but it cannot raise up your spirit. But you are not only body. Fulfilling the need of the body is not sufficient. You need to learn to fulfill the need of your spirit. You have to keep alive your spirit. You know about Joe Lucas, a great man, very rich man. I was told with 41,000 square feet, he built a beautiful house. 41,000. He went to Gulf country for work and he died with corona. He might have never thought. And they just buried his body. That's all. What is the use of winning the whole world? Don't look only at your needs of your. You are much more than your physical need. God is looking at your spirit to build up your spirit, to build up your faith, to make you rich in the Lord, rich in heaven. So he tells them, don't worry about the food that your God can give it to you even today. He can make miracle for you. I am the living bread. Eat me. I'm the blood. I'm going to die for you. You will die in your sin, but I don't want you to die in sin. So I will give. I will do everything possible. I will lay down my life. I will shed my blood. And I will buy you. And the enemy cannot destroy you. You are much more than your body. You are much more than your life. You are much more than your life be on this earth. You are going to live beyond this earth. Your God is concerned about you. Not only today, he is concerned about tomorrow. He is concerned that you should be with him always. They could not understand. What? He is going to give his body? He is going to give his blood for us? How can we eat? Are we here to eat his body? Or are we, have we become headache for him that he is telling? They did not understand him. When you do not listen to his word, only when we listen to him, we will understand his spirit. And he is there to raise up our spirit. And he gives us that kind of word. That's why seeing everybody leaving, Jesus asked Peter, "My son, do you also want to go away?" Because he knows there are people who are with him are going to deny him, betray him. But his love for them is so much, he can't afford to lose. "I have loved them till the end," he said. He is loving you and me till the end. He thinks about our need before, beyond us. He's going before us. You only think about your daughter's, maybe education. He is concerned about your daughter's marriage also. He will prepare, how is her future? So he will be preparing the base. He is our God, a living God. Yes. Blessed are those who are alert to the truth and move with the Lord who moves with us. The God of compassion. A lady came and cried to God, God's servant Elijah, and saying, Sir, my husband was a prophet, very good, but he made a debt problem, so what? So the debt is so much, the people who gave the money, they are trying to catch my sons also. The heart of the prophet looked at the Lord. The Lord said, "What are you looking at, man?" "I am looking at them. I am looking at them." The word of God was given to the prophet. Ask her what she is having. She said, "What I have," scratching her head. Today you also may be scratching your head. Now Corona has come, lockdown has come. People are saying this income. If he has led you with 1 lakh rupees per month, is it the 1 lakh or the Lord who led you? And the Lord who led you with 1 lakh, he can also take care of you with 10,000. He is sufficient enough. Have the faith. At the end you will see the money is left out. How? Don't ask me how. Because our God is a God who does not only miracle, he is also one who takes care of our needs. Yes. He is a God of miracle. He is a God who cares for us. Yes. And he said to her, "Go and bring all the empty vessels." What do you have? 1 bottle of oil, enough. With what you have, God will fulfill your need and the needs of everybody. So he told her, "Go and find out empty bottles in your." And everybody said, "All our bottles are empty only. The whole village is empty." So God came. So for every bottle will have some oil. And God fulfilled. With that little oil, they poured, all the empty vessels were filled. Their debts were fulfilled. I'm sure that family might have fed the whole village. Because all of them gave the empty vessels. And today all their stomachs became full. Our God is a mighty God. We belong to such a mighty loving God. And we are privileged to belong to him. And that's why Peter said, "Lord, to whom shall we go? To whom shall we go? For you have the words of eternal life." You say a word and the eternal heaven responds. You say a word, life responds. Because we read in Genesis chapter 26 verse 12, when there was drought, Abraham's son Isaac is looking at God. "Lord, what shall I do?" The Lord says, "Sow the seed, man." He never thought, "Oh my God, he's asking me, little seed I have. I'm going to throw that in the drought." That also may go. No, he saw his God. Don't see what you have. See your God. And when he saw that, "Thank you, Daddy. I was waiting for this word. You are asking me to sow. Thank you." So the whole village might have been wondering, what's wrong with this Isaac? The little also he's having is crack, throwing and putting into the dry sand, but Isaac knows the Lord. Everybody sees what they have. Isaac saw the Lord, the greatest treasure he has. And we know the Bible says Isaac got hundredfold. The day he might have sown, God might have sent the rain. He knows what to do. All that we need to do is listen to his voice and raise up your spirit. The flesh is no need, no use. We are having the flesh for some time, but you are more than that. Raise up your spirit. The enemy will come to constantly attack your spirit with fear, worries, anxiety. Rise up. Tell to your soul, why are you afraid, worried? Rise up. Your God is with you. The problems are today, they may be trying to change your mind, but your God is forever. He never changes. His prosperity for you never changes. His compassion for you never changes. Maybe the problem is trying to change your mind, change your spirit. Evil is trying to use your situation and try to put down your spirit. Oh, what will I do? What shall will happen to you? No. Your God never changes. Hebrews 13:8. He is the same God of compassion. He is the same God of glory. He is the same God who with the 5 loaves feeds 5,000 people. He is the same God who has made you his child and died for you, shed his blood for you.